Robert Hodierno, Military Times. The war in Iraq is only a week old, and one photograph already has become an icon. I was just one of a group of guys, Dwyer said. I wasn't standing out more than anyone else. For his family,
and Ronnie said, Newsday. It's an image of this war that touches, inspires, and reassures. An armed soldier in fatigues and helmet, carefully cradling in his arms a small, half-naked Iraqi boy.
Chris Waddy, National Post. The soldier in the picture, Private First Class Joseph Dwyer, is still in the field, and, until yesterday, had no idea that he was famous.
When I told him he was on the cover of USA Today and tons of newspapers around the world and around the States, he was blown away and couldn't really believe it, that this photograph had become, you know, somewhat famous and that people recognized it and wanted to speak to his family and him about it. He was very humble and very shyly embarrassed. If you look at the photograph, there's a really sort of interesting contrast between the two faces, between Joseph and Ali's face. Joseph's very focused. He was focused on where he was running the child to. The first couple frames, he's looking down at the child, checking out the child, and then he's looking straight up and straight ahead at where he's running to. And the entire time, Ali's face is just fear. I mean, he's in between crying and panicking and fearful. And there's actually a really nice photograph of one of the lieutenants who was a doctor holding Ali's hand the entire time while everyone else was treating Ali. One large soldier's dirty hand and one little boy's hand. And there was one moment where the lieutenant had stopped holding his hand for a second, and one of the other commanding officers barked at him and said, "Your job is to hold that child's hand the entire time while he's getting treatment." Ali's leg had not really healed well. Yeah, the family had told us that they had taken him to the hospital numerous times, but they were, you know, just a farming family and didn't have any more money or any more resources to take care of him, and that he walked with a pretty painful limp, so most of the time the family carried him. So I spoke to one of the people at the Red Cross in Baghdad at the time and said, "Hey, is there any way you can help this kid out? Can you help this family out? Can you send somebody down there to just show him some physical therapy exercises he can do or things he could do with his leg to help him walk again?" And the Red Cross told me, quote, "We don't help onesies and twosies," meaning that they couldn't just help one person at a time or two people at a time. They needed to help larger numbers. As we were leaving, and I have a photograph of this where the father is holding Ali in his arms and an airplane goes overhead. And Ali sort of looks up at the sky with a panicked look in his face. And the father is pointing at the airplane, and the father told us that every time an airplane goes over, Ali is still terrified of it. So, you know, Ali in his own way was also representative of what happened after the war. You know, Joseph had his own inner demons that he was struggling with, and so did Ali.
For NPR News, I'm Rose Hoban in Durham, North Carolina. Police say when they kicked open the door to Dwyer's home, he was still alive, but he was having trouble breathing.
We got a call that he was barricaded in his residence. He was hallucinating about there being Iraqis in the house and wanting to call in airstrikes and that sort of thing.
Dwyer died in the ambulance on the way to the hospital. He'd been inhaling aerosol chemicals from cans of compressed air. Dwyer's death has been ruled an accidental overdose.
One of the things that his mother said was that Joseph never came home from Iraq. He came back physically, but he never came home from Iraq and was never the same.
Just couldn't get over the war. He just couldn't do it. He wanted... just wasn't Joseph. Joseph never came home.
I think that Joseph is a battlefield casualty, just as if he'd been shot on the battlefield, even though he actually physically died in North Carolina. He might as well have just been killed by a sniper's bullet in Iraq. It's the same thing. During the war, when that photograph came out, people thought it was very sort of symbolic of America's effort in Iraq, and thought that photograph sort of symbolized what America was trying to do in Iraq at the time. And I think in its own way now, the photograph is very symbolic of what's happening in the war today. And that's, there's tens of thousands hundreds of thousands of soldiers that are coming home physically and mentally wounded. The military trains these guys to go to war, but it doesn't train them to come home from war. They don't know how to come home from war. Joseph, while he represented the soldiers during the invasion in that photograph, to an extent now represents the soldiers after they come home from war and the effects that linger with them. It is ironic that the photograph that brought fame to Joseph Dwyer, that everyone knew, is a photograph of Joseph Dwyer trying to save life. And in the end, he wasn't able to save his own.